Despite another wave of deadly COVID-19 coronavirus infections ravaging Moscow and spreading out into the provinces, the Russian authorities went ahead with staging the MAX 2021 air and space show on the outskirts of Moscow, in Zhukovsky. MAX international aerospace shows have been held every 2 years in Zhukovsky since 1993, to demonstrate Russia's capability to build modern civilian and military aircraft, air defense systems and space missiles. The most promoted entry at MAX 2021 was a mysterious new stealth fighter. Photos of the aircraft partially covered up were circulated before MAX 2021 with a provocative slogan that simply asked, "Do you want to see me naked?" The new plane, revealed and demonstrated to the public and Putin on July 20, turned out to be a model of a light, one-engine fighter jet designed by the Sukhoi Aircraft Design and Production Company, which is part of the United Aircraft Building Corporation. Defense industry representatives say the Checkmate plane may receive the designation SU-75, but that has not been officially confirmed. Rostec and UAC disclosed that they are promoting and producing the Checkmate on their own initiative, practically exclusively designed for export to African nations, perhaps Egypt or Algeria, and Asian nations like their longtime clients India and Vietnam. The Checkmate's production run is planned to be up to 300 units, if there will be enough orders. According to Rostec, the jet will be cheap in exploitation compared to the US F-35 Lightning II, and the price tag will be under $30 million apiece. Rostec is offering African and Asian countries possible co-production of the fighter. Checkmate's low observable features are numerous. The chin air intake with its distinctive underbite strongly hints that Sukhoi's engineers incorporated a divertless inlet that could partially obscure the fighter's most radar-reflective component, its engine turbine. The inlet alone could account for much of Checkmate's stealth. Now consider Checkmate's tail. Instead of separate horizontal and vertical stabilizers with moving rudders and elevators, the new fighter has what are called rudervators. A pair of single-piece control surfaces that cant at roughly 45-degree angles relative to the horizontal plane of the fuselage. Rudervators can help to reduce the number of highly detectable surfaces on a jet while still affording it good maneuverability. Wings and horizontal control surfaces with their straight edges and huge surface areas are a major source of radar reflectivity. Vertical stabilizers also are radar reflectors from certain angles relative to the enemy. Eliminate the horizontal and vertical stabilizers and you've cut the number of edges and flat surfaces off which radar energy can reflect back to the emitter. The problem is that an airplane needs elevators and rudders. Rudervators essentially combine both elements while mitigating their observability. A whole angled rudervator moves, pushing the jet's nose up or down and to one side or the other, and it does so without offering radars on the ground strictly horizontal or vertical surfaces off which to bounce their energy. Checkmate's rudervators likely make it stealthier than, say, a MiG-29, but not without a cost. Rudervators require sophisticated flight control systems. Sukhoi obviously decided the downside of rudervators is worth the upside. That is to say, their stealthiness is worth the difficulty in controlling them. Local and foreign media described the Checkmate presented at the air show in Zhukovsky as reminiscent of the American-made F-35 jet. UAC representatives told reporters that the new plane will cost between $25 million and $30 million. An F-35 costs about $90 million. The Checkmate is designed as a short takeoff and landing fighter jet, a feature that lends itself to operating from aircraft carrier flight decks and runways damaged by enemy action. The plane has a combat radius of 1,500 kilometers or 932 miles, or the distance a Checkmate that's fully laden with missiles and bombs can travel, fight, and then return to base. The fighter jet features an unusually pointy nose and an engine intake below the cockpit. The Checkmate also has an internal weapons bay designed to preserve its anti-radar shaping and can carry both air-to-air and air-to-ground ordnance, including both infrared and radar-guided air-to-air missiles, air-to-ground and anti-ship missiles, guided and unguided bombs, and unguided rockets. The plane will have a top speed of 1,180 miles per hour. Sukhoi, in a dig against the F-35, says the Checkmate is capable of continuous supersonic flight, a nod to last year's revelation the F-35 can only fly supersonic for 50 seconds before possibly damaging the plane. Sukhoi claims its aircraft is capable of 8 grams maneuvers. The Checkmate, like the F-35, can share data in the air with other fighter jets. The new fighter will also come in an unmanned version, opening up the possibility that one man Checkmate might control several unmanned versions in battle. UAC promises 3 configurations: basic, medium, and full, though it's not clear what any of that means. The fighter will feature a streamlined maintenance system. Then there's the Checkmate's claimed unit price of $25 to $30 million. That's less than half the flyaway cost of the F-35. Which currently costs about $78 million. UAC says the first Checkmate will fly in 2023, with actual deliveries of CTO commence in 2026-27.